early on in the 1820s and 1830s, there were attempts made to reapportion the legislature back then because people felt it wasn't fair and it was not sufficiently based upon population. Nothing ever happened, however, until the early 1960s, 140 years later, when some court decisions were made that said, yeah, it isn't fair. There isn't equal voting access in Vermont because of the one representative per town structure of the House in particular. And what you had, and maybe the most stark way to illustrate that is that the town of Stratton had 38 people and one member of the Vermont House. And Burlington had over 35,000 people and had one member of the House. After that litigation, the dust cleared in the early to mid 1960s, the legislature reapportioned itself and established the apportionment board to come into being and start working every 10 years. About 18 months prior to when the legislature had to do its own final version of a new map. So the apportionment board has met about five or six times now every 10 years. And we are, in a sense, advisory to the legislature. But we take that role very seriously and we'll be trying to provide the legislature with as much data and research and redistricting options as we can. We will be issuing an initial House map, sort of a preliminary House map, and sending it out to all the towns, publishing it on our website and all of that. And a town that disagrees with how it's been placed in a district, particularly a town that we propose to subdivide or to put into a two-member district. Those towns have the right to hold a public hearing, take testimony, and then send us a counterproposal or criticisms of our initial mapping proposal. All those comments will be coming back to us from the boards of civil authority in each town. And the board of civil authority in each town is the select board members and the justices of the peace, plus the town clerk. And that unit of government is chosen in large part because in towns, it's the board of civil authority that has a sort of oversight authority over local elections. And they have some local expertise in that regard. We've asked the public, do you have a preference in general over a single member House district versus a two member House district? And do you feel strongly about the importance of following town lines and keeping towns intact? Do you prefer single member Senate districts? Should we go to all single member Senate districts, for example? And the apportionment board did a version of that 10 years ago just to see what it would look like. And it doesn't look at all like a county map, no surprise. Under our statute, we're supposed to get all of this stuff done by the end of July. But since the U.S. Census Bureau has failed to send us the data that we need, the legislature enacted some changes that pushed this out into the late summer and into the fall. So if I had to make an estimate of when we would be getting this map out to the towns, I would say sometime in the middle to the end of September.
Well, let's be in touch when those maps are drawn so that we can generate some more interest. And in the meantime, I really appreciate your time and the work of the apportionment board, the Legislative Apportionment Board, in making sure that we get the kind of representation that we deserve in the state of Vermont.